Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Okay, so I'm going to be traveling soon, so this is probably going to be my last one for a little bit, but I'm going to share with you guys some outstanding questions that you have asked me, and this should take, I don't know, a few minutes. I don't think it'll take that long. Okay, so the question I want to start with is, for those of you that are not able to make it to the Dream Program, not the one in Copenhagen, if you're not able to make it in the program in Dallas, or the program in Toronto, which are all going to be announced. I think tomorrow's the date that we're announcing all of the other locations also, inshallah. But if you're not able to make that and you're only able to study at home, I want to give you some advice about that. If you're not able to attend physically any of the programs and you want to study online, how do you do that effectively for Quranic Arabic? So the first recommendation I have is similar to what I started with. You want to have an intensive start. And it's really hard to study online on your own if you're not self-disciplined. It's a very, very difficult thing to pull off because your motivation tapers off. And even if you put in a couple of hours in the beginning, if you let that taper off, all that work you did in the beginning will disappear. This is the thing about Arabic studies. You can't just do 10 hours or 12 hours and then take a break and then come back and pick up from where you left off. That's not gonna happen. You will forget what you did and you're gonna have to start all over again. So it's counterproductive. You have to reach a certain minimum milestone, and until then, you've got to keep pushing. And if after that milestone, if you slow it down or take a more relaxed schedule approach, that's okay. But until you get there, you can't. You can't actually take a break and, you know, just think that the casual pace at which you're learning is going to work. So for those of you that are not familiar, I have a couple of versions of Quranic Arabic teaching that I've put out there for you guys to consume. Of course, the Dream Program is the complete comprehensive curriculum. I've also got a video series where I taught my daughters, Waliya and Husna, the same curriculum, but a much lighter version of that curriculum. So it's teaching the same, grammar, morphology. I didn't teach them rhetoric. I didn't go that far with them. But at least these basics and some essential application to one surah of the Quran or one portion of a surah of the Quran, Surah Al-Kahf, I taught them that, and that series is called the Arabic with Husna series. It's on bayina.tv, that series is not for everyone. Let me just tell you what the purpose of that series was. It's short videos, and I wanted to teach them little by little by little. And of course, they're my kids, so I get to reinforce with them quite a bit too. If you're going to do that, and first of all, if you can't afford to do it, get a gift subscription to Bayina TV. It doesn't cost you anything, okay? So if you're not able to afford a subscription to Bayina TV, get a gift subscription. We'll try to, someone in the world will sponsor your subscription, inshallah ta'ala, and that should be okay. If you're going to do it, then unit one of that curriculum, you do it 20 days in a row, no breaks. Do it every single day. Do 2-3 videos a day until you're done with unit one. You can take a break after that, but not before then. If you start doing it once a week, twice a week, one video a day, a little bit casual, it's not going to work for you. I'm just telling you, that's just not how it's going to work. Unit one has to be done, condensed form. And then, inshallah ta'ala, you can, slow it down and do the rest of the units. A lot of you asked what the difference is between the Dream Program and the Arabic with Husna curriculum. That's, of course, online already on Bayina TV. Of course, previously, some of you are familiar, Bayina used to teach a program called the Access program. And what's the difference between Access and Dream and Arabic with Husna? So these are the three basic programs that we've had. So I wanted to explain the difference between them to you also, so you're clear. The thing is that the Dream program is the most comprehensive, where I want you to apply and not skip any details and give you the Quranic application very, very directly. The Access program was much of the grammar that I teach and much of the concepts that are taught in the Dream program, but not all of them. And it's not as application heavy as the Dream program is going to be. And it's not as hands-on as the Dream program is going to be. We have to go quite a bit. And of course, the Access program was taught by my TAs. And I actually only maybe visited some of the Access programs, but I didn't teach any of the Access courses myself. So the Access program was taught by Arabic teachers, but they don't bring to the curriculum my Quran background. So what I try to do when I teach is, my 20 years of Quran study, I incorporate them into the Arabic curriculum. So that's going to be part of the Dream curriculum, but it wasn't part of the Access curriculum. as far as the Arabic with Husna curriculum, which is on Bayina TV still, is concerned, that curriculum is actually meant for kids and those of you that just want to do it on self-paced to get an easy, light start into Quranic Arabic study. So if you are coming to the Dream Program or planning to come in a future date and you'd like to get a head start, Arabic with Husna is a good place to start. Get your feet wet, get a little bit familiarized with the material so that when you get the full-on version, when I teach the Dream Program, you're not just getting hit with some new material, you're actually kind of acclimated to some of the stuff that's been taught. So inshallah, for those of you that can't attend any of these, I recommend you get started with Arabic with Husna. And that even there's recommendations on how to do that. Again, the unit one, just kind of do it in a concentrated way and then taper off from there. I'm really, really excited. I'm just actually the reason I didn't do an earlier session today is because I was packing and just getting around, getting chores done. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to finish that stuff and get on my journey and get a head start also and meet many of the students that are coming. Actually, there are, and I think now over 20 countries represented at the Dream Program in Copenhagen. People from 20 different countries have already signed up and are coming. So I'm really, really excited to see you guys. And I'm very honored that you've put that trust in me. And I hope that I'm able to live up to that trust that you've given me, inshallah. So the last thing I want to share with all of you for today, it's not going to be a long thing, is that if you are going to study Quranic Arabic, I'll tell you what I needed to keep going. Is don't just study Quranic Arabic. Study Quran alongside Quranic Arabic and memorize Quran alongside both of those things. If you're not in the habit of memorizing the Quran, get into that habit. And I might even do some sessions later on how to memorize the Quran, or maybe even set some goals for you guys. Let's get a few thousand people to do a few ayat in a week together. And you guys can post your recitations or something. Like, let's do this together as a community and get you in the habit of memorizing a little bit of the Quran, even if you're not memorizing Surah Al-Baqarah or one whole page or something that's too hard for you. That's okay. Let's start with something small and let's get you in that habit, because there's no point at all studying the Arabic of the Quran and not memorizing. It's like, why are you even doing it? Okay? Because the only way you'll retain is your recitation, your prayer. That itself will become a review of all of the Arabic. That's going to become a review of all the Arabic. So that's really cool that, inshallah, you'll be able to do that and keep and strengthen your relationship with Arabic and the Quran at the same time. That's what we want to do. We want to build those both of those things at the same time. So inshallah ta'ala, you'll hear more about that soon. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Oh, and by the way, I'm not going to fix the alarm. Nope. I'm going to keep it. I like it. I rather enjoy it. I mean, it bothers you. I kind of like that it bothers you. Yeah, yeah. And some of you have comments about my beard. Go ahead. Not short. It's fine. I like it. Bye. Bye.